dropping by. This is part 6 in the Oncidium Alliance series, which is another repot. Well, the second of two, so no more to come for some considerable time. And we've already had this out of the pot earlier in the series, so we know in a way what to expect. This is the Oncidium Katrinzok Make, and it is starting its new growths. So the new growths are coming. There will be more. Whether any of these bulbs are capable of producing two new growths, we'll have to wait and see. But my main concern with this was what it was in, which was this cocoa fibre stuff. Now I have learnt to deal with this when I do get plants that are not in a position to repot, and that is just don't get it soaking wet. The thing I say you should never do with an orchid, which is just give it a dribble, I always say if you're going to water it, get on and water it. This stuff, in my environment, is the exception to the rule. Because if you get this absolutely soaking wet, it can stay wet for so long, just one bad watering like that can start the roots rotting. Now, this looks like a good root system, but I can already tell it's not. There's an awful lot of dead root material in here. My main concern, which we will find out in a minute, is that they've dumped two plants in the pot and we end up with two much smaller plants. I'm just about to find out. I'm pretty sure that's two plants down the centre there. Yeah, it might not be, but it's difficult to see how it became the shape it is from that centre point going outwards in two directions. And the chances are it's just the tangled root mass that's holding it together, and nothing more. And this does happen, you know, and sometimes plants end up staying together because at the repot stage it's not actually realised that it's two plants. But the one thing it hasn't got is any additional, oh yes it has, yeah. It has the remnants of the original sphagnum plug. And it did look like one, not two. So in theory we have got a joined up plant here. Well, unless it falls apart when I rinse this lot under the tap, then it can stay together. No, it's going to come apart, I can see. It's two plants, I thought it was. If it wasn't, it is now. Right, so dealing with this plant first. We have a single new growth there. So while I'm at it, I'm taking the sheaths off, hidey holes for bugs. They're better off than left on. There's another new growth there. Just an embryo new growth, just literally. That's why I was going very careful. There's a little tiny new growth there, and I'm going to leave that together even if it's not actually joined. And it looks like we found another new growth here. So what does that, so we got one here, two, where was that, and three, that little embryo one. That may not take off because the other new growth is on the same bulb. If it does, it means it's capable of producing two new growths on a bulb, which is good. Which means this one here may well push out another one later down the line. So that's not a bad plant. I'm a little concerned that that wobbles, but it is joined. So I will get the hydrogen peroxide on that. That's why I left it to become almost dry. And a lot of these roots are gone. But by the time I've trimmed this lot, I don't think there's going to be a huge amount of root system left. But we've got three new growths. They will produce their own roots soon. When, I don't know, it's a new plant. But it won't be long. So that's one. They're capable of producing incredibly long roots. That was actually wrapped around, it's dangling down now. Unfortunately, it's a dead one. Right, so hydrogen peroxide on that, because I have found one tiny little snail on this one, long time ago. and I haven't seen any since. That doesn't mean to say there's none lurking in there, so we'll have a go at that. Another good reason for getting the sheaths out of the way. There's some less places to hide. So that's one piece. Ugh. Next piece. Now this one's got a stronger new growth showing at that point. And I suspect there's another one in there, yeah. So this bulb has two new growths. That's two so far. Might not be any more on this one. No, I think that's it on this one. And this has got quite a few bulbs that are not really of any use anymore. These few, 1, 2, 3, 4, they can come off. They're not serving any purpose on this piece of plant. Oh, hang on, we've got another new growth in there. So that's three. And if that one's got one that side, I bet there's one lurking in there. I can't see it, not yet. But three, potential for four. So we're okay, sorry, yeah, three with the potential for four. Now in this case, see those new growths were coming up inside of the dry sheaths, which easily peel off. This new growth is coming up inside a green leaf. They don't peel off so easy, but they will if you're careful. Yeah. Reason is that when the new growths come out, they go straight in the media and don't shoot upwards. So they're much likely to get going quicker. Right, so again, that's a reasonable piece of plant. I suspect there are some roots on here that are viable, but a lot of them aren't. Don't get, if you get stuff in this cocoa fibre stuff, it has a staining effect on white roots. In a pure media, like if that was in an inorganic media, the roots would stay white. And it makes it a lot easier to see when they're dry as well, because they'll normally turn a greenish tinge even on Oncidiums when they're wet, and then they dry out again. And you can see the difference between the nice green root tips. There isn't one single green root tip on either of these pieces of plant. So there's no actively growing roots. So these plants are going to have to support themselves on old, tired roots until the new ones get going. Which shouldn't be too long. And the bulbs are slightly desiccated, but they've got good leaves, so they can feed themselves through the leaves and hopefully keep going long enough to get new root systems going. So again, hydrogen peroxide. I'm not going to show trimming. I did that quite elaborately on the previous one. It's just a matter of feeling the roots. If they just crush and there's no substance to them, whatever colour they are doesn't matter. But this stuff stains the roots and makes them look old and tired and dead, when some of them might not be. So you still got to do your work. You still got to, you know, treat each root. Look at it. See if it's... I mean, that's a paler coloured root. It's had it. It's gone. Just pulls off. There's no substance to it. So we'll have a clean up. Do the hydrogen peroxide spray. And like I did before, down in the leaf crevices, all in between the rhizomes, all in here, yeah, everywhere, absolutely soak the roots, right up under the base of the plant, make sure everything gets a good soak. I was asked after the last one, why don't I spray the whole plant? First of all, hydrogen peroxide is not cheap, and what would be the point in spraying that leaf? Just look, there's nothing on it, it's a clean leaf. So I don't like wastage, basically. I will spray where I think there could be bugs, snails, yeah, and pathogens. They don't tend to be on leaves. So I'll get that done and then I'll be back. Ow! Oof. Okay, I've had a clean up. There's still the odd root left on here that's probably gone, but I have to think about the fact that I want these plants to actually hold on to the media. Yeah? So leaving some of the older ones on this time needs doing. You're going to see something you wouldn't normally see. What do I always do with oncidium types when I repot them? Smallest pot I can possibly get them in. Yeah. Unfortunately this time I do have two plants, and where this plant lives on my humidity tray in the house, which is where these are being grown, there's only room for one pot. So for once I'm going to put both plants in the same pot, which is as it was, and it will be a bigger pot as a consequence. Yeah? How do you turn a bigger pot into a smaller pot? Deep crocking. And I've chosen this pot deliberately. It's got a hell of a lot of air in the bottom. A hell of a lot, which also takes up, this air cone takes up quite a bit of space. That's over an inch deep, that air cone. So that's using up a lot of the bottom of the pot. Plus, very heavy on the crocking, now makes it a lot shallower. If the roots want to get down into there and head out the bottom of the pot, that's up to them. But that's not going to happen overnight, is it? So now, the same as on the last one, because it's come out of that cocoa fibre stuff, it's been used to having not a lot of air around the roots. So, you know, quite compact media, touching the roots in every possible place. And to help transition it from that environment to one with some more air, it's going to go into small bark and heavy on the moss. So for a while, it can stay quite wet. And then as soon as those new roots come, they go into the new environment. They won't know what the plant was in before, they will only know the new media, and they will immediately acclimatize to that media because it's all they've ever known. And then they'll be used to more air around them, and then at a subsequent repot, which is probably quite a long way off, they can go in maybe a small and medium bark mix without the moss, or maybe with just a small amount of moss. But if you do those sort of changes gradually, you don't lose as many roots. You do it in one big go. If I took those plants now and put them in large bark, I suspect every single root would die, because they just wouldn't be used to that amount of air around them. Plus the large bark in itself just wouldn't stay wet, would it? So you have to do these changes gradually. That's not enough. More. Going a bit careful squeezing this moss, because somewhere in this little batch is a thorn. It caught the side of my hand as I was getting it out of the bag, but I missed it. I didn't see where it went. No, my luck, it's gone back in the bag and it will get me next time. So far I haven't found it. Right, how are we doing now? That's a bit better. So there's quite a bit of moss there. It's broken up quite small. The reason for breaking it up small is it distributes itself into more places in the pot. If you get the larger pieces, you could end up with part of the pot that's nearly all moss, and other parts of the pot with no moss at all. That's the reason for breaking it up small. Right, now you two better stand up, because these are quite tall plants. Right, so some of the new media on top of the crocking. Now let's see if we can. First of all, we need to work out which way round these are going to go. Right, well this one's obvious, because all three new growths are on this side of the plant. There aren't any that side. So under normal circumstances, that side of that plant would go right up against the pot to leave room for these new ones. But it's going to go in the middle, because it's got another plant to get in there as well. So this will be off the centre. The back of the plant will be right in the centre. Now on this one, I suspect it's going to be awkward and there'll be new growths coming out. Right, it looks like we've got new growths here, here, and here, but not here. So the area where there aren't any new growths goes up the air, goes against the area on that bit with no new growths, and they become the centre of what's going to go in the pot. Yeah? Now, when the two plants are together and it goes in this big pot, it looks like it's going in a small pot. Yeah, you see what I'm getting at? The fact that there's two plants It's now quite squashed in. So again, gently, and look at what you're doing. I'm making sure that as I wibble my finger, the bark is going in underneath the plant in what would have been a void if I hadn't done this. And I'm still keeping the plant over a bit while I get some media in what I'll call this side. Yeah, but I'm making sure it's getting in underneath the plant as well, and also being very careful not to poke off the new growths as you push your fingers around. So easy to knock new growths off when you're doing this. You know, if I put my finger down suddenly there, it would just snap off. So you've got to go careful. So that's one side done. Now what we can do is turn the pot round and push the plant quite hard against that media, opening up this side. Yeah, and again, check for gaps. I mean, I'm actually using feel now rather than sight, because with my back I can't bend over. So I'm having to feel my way around. Well, I was thinking, you know, what else can I do standing up that would be of use? And I thought, well, this Oncidium Alliance series really, it hasn't come to a close. I mean, this little set of three series that I've done, the Cattleya one, the Phalaenopsis one, and this one, they can go on forever. But there will be periods when there's nothing happening, you know, to actually say anything about. I mean, the next thing that will happen will probably just be an update to see how they're doing, because every single plant in both series has been potted. Or mounted, I think, in one case. So, you know, we'll do an update, see how the new growths are doing. But apart from that, nothing much is going to happen. I mean, these aren't going to get repotted for a hell of a long time. Right, the top of the pot doesn't necessarily need the moss. See, I know there's a gap down there because I can feel the plant moving. So we'll get some bark in. The plant's going to be sitting very near the surface of the pot, which probably means when I water, half the bark will come out. But after a while, it will stop doing it, and it'll settle down. See, now I've just broken that new growth. That's because I'm not bending over to see what I'm doing. I don't know how many we had, but we've got one less now. It happens. I'd rather it didn't. We won't knock any more off. I've just got a bare bit there. Just about enough. Just about enough to finish off. Now again, the fact that it's an Oncidium type, base of the pseudo bulbs just under the media. Now if it was a Cattleya, they'd be sitting on the top. But as it's an Oncidium type, they like to just be tucked in, but not buried. If you bury them, you're liable to get some rotting. Right, we'll give it a tap. Settle everything in. Remember watching one person doing this, and they hadn't actually pressed the media down very firmly, quite honestly. I think I might actually put some stakes on this one. I'll be back. Okay, now I probably won't need to tie the stakes to anything. I just need to stop the plant wobbling. So I'm just going to push one down there, up against the pseudo bulb. And that'll stop that leaning forward and wobbling. And then on this side, we need to find a similar suitable place. Where my thumb is looks about reasonable. So we'll put one down in there and hold that large pseudo bulb. That's better. So just those two stakes are holding it in place now, and it's stopped wobbling. I haven't tied anything. They're just down in the media. Right, so apart from that area there, just needs a little bit more. Final check now. Sure. growths have got media right up to the base of them, but not buried. And the new roots will go straight down in the pot. So that's that one done. I'll keep the original tag, even though it's all loose and floppy. That's if it'll go in. It's so flimsy that it just buckles as you try and push it in. Oh well, it's in there now. So there we go, that's that one done. That is annoying, but it happens. That's probably the first time you've ever seen me do it on camera in all the years, but that doesn't mean it hasn't been done before. It just means you haven't seen me do it before. And that's a shame. That was a nice new growth. You know, that's one less. That potentially is a flower spike gone in quite a long period of time. But hopefully the ones we have got left will push on now. 1, 2, 3 there. And I think there was 3 around the other side, but now there's probably only 2 because we knocked one off, or I did. What's this we? Okay, so that's that one done. And as I said, in this set of 3 series, there isn't much going on for a while now. I mean, the next thing that could possibly happen in the Phalaenopsis series is the 2 spikes that were cut might start to shoot out. Well, I'll come back if they do. Or if the spikes start to die back, I'll come back and we'll cut them back to the base. And the others, it's just a matter of looking for changes and developments, at which point we can do an update. But at the moment, that's probably it for a while now. Now that one will have a good watering, a really good watering, because it's come from a media with virtually no air in it, therefore it was touching. And now it has got a little bit of air around it, so I want it wet. So that'll get a good soaking now, and I'll have to keep my eye on it. New bark will dry quickly, even though there's a reasonable amount of moss in there. So the watering frequency on a repotted plant, you might be surprised how quick it comes round, especially with this Orchiata bark. Because certainly when it's new, it really holds no water. You get it wet, but it's not really soaking any in until it starts to age a bit. So that's that one done, and see you next time.